We've got to show the lure, we got it on.
The $4 one.
The $4 lure, mate, the $4 slayer.
Here we're back.
There's trouble.
Oh, no, what lure did we get it on?
$4 slayer.
Yeah.
So we're going to take a look at how to make a lure I've been calling the $4 slayer. Although its original name isn't the $4 slayer, some great fishermen like Bill Hall and Bruce Smith have long been using a film canister as the basis of their lure, and it had been known as the Kodak Killer or the Kodak Crusher, because this little piece of equipment here makes an excellent head for a marlin lure. And you can pick these up from any chemist that develops film or Photoshop. They'll gladly give them to you, they just throw them away otherwise. And the other components that I've got here, we've got some 300 pound Suffolk leader that I'm going to use. We've got a little bit of plastic piping that's optional. A washer, which is an addition that I've sort of added to the whole rig, which actually improves the lure. A couple of skirts. Now this is where I got the name $4 slayer. These were $2 each in a bargain bin at a closing down sale at a tackle store. So I bought a whole bag of them and I made up these $4 lures that have caught me literally hundreds of marlin using this film canister and a couple of simple marlin skirts. And of course this bit, it's very important. It's gonna cost you a little bit as well, is the hook. Now this is a VMC hook, stainless steel, very strong. But I've pre-sharpened it. Now it's critical that your hook is sharpened correctly. It will increase your hookup rate and your catch rate. So please check it out. We've done a video on exactly how to do it right here on ultimatefishing.tv. And those are all the components of the lure. For tools, just some mono cutters, a lighter, crimping pliers, and a drill. So we'll rip straight into it and we'll start with the lure head. You don't need the old bit on the back of the film canister, and we're just making a hole for the leader. Now you can get something sharp and just poke it in there, but it makes a neater job if you just drill a wee hole, and we try and make the hole about the same diameter as our bit of plastic tube. Rightio. There's our hole. Now next, if we get our wee bit of tube, and I'm just burning one end of a bit of plastic tube just to get sort of a little rounded lip. Now you see by melting that's created just a nice rounded off sort of an edge and a bit of a lip. Now I poke my bit of tube back up through the bottom of the film canister and it just stops on that lip that we've created. So that locks in there. Now I cut that off quite snug with my cutters. I'm going to add my washer over the top and then I'm going to burn it again just to make a nice melted edge. Press that down and that in fact holds the washer in place. And we've got a nice little bit there. That's the head all done. Washer on top. Maybe it offers a little bit of front weight. I don't know. I run it like that. Catch lots of marlin on it. So now it's time to add our leader. Now I'm just going to select about 7.5 meters of leader. My arm span's approximately 1.5 meters, so 5 of these. Now, I'm going to just poke down through the front of the lure head. That's a nice snug fit. Then I'm going to poke through my top skirt. And then I'm going to poke through the bottom skirt. And this is where you're going to start to see this starting to take shape and starting to look like a marlin or a trolling lure. Now we've just got to add the hook, which is really simple. So I've got three crimps here. I've got to make sure that they're the right diameter. These are 2 mil crimps, or 1.9s perhaps. I'm just sliding those onto the leader, both crimps onto the leader. And I'm taking a guesstimate, once I double the line over, how much length I'm going to need. And then we just sort of test that. So I'm looking at the length of that, saying about there, doubled over. And I'm going to take another little bit of my plastic tube, slide the hook on, and I slide my first crimp up into position. Now this is just getting a rough sort of position set. Once I'm happy there, I'm just sort of folding the tube over and pushing the crimp up just to get that hook sitting about right. And it's now that I'm just going to twist the two. I think it's known as the Avalon rig. It's a great way for making a single rig. In fact, I rig most of my marlin lures like this with a single hook. I twist it around a few times. I'm taking a bit of a guesstimate at how long I'm going to need it. And it's important that you always make it too long to start with, because it's easy to trim, but you've got to start again if you make it too short. So I'm just going to sit the crimps in place at the moment. That's all a little bit bent. I'm not worried about that at the moment. I'm just worried about getting my length right. So once I put that in place, look at that. I've got the hook there, just right at the back of the skirt. Gape of the hook just hanging out. That's where I like it. So I got it right first time. I don't need to trim anymore. And this is where I get to crimp it into position. So first off, I crimp my bottom crimp. And whenever we're crimping, make sure everything's up nice and firm. Squeeze the crimpers down and roll the crimp over. You shouldn't crimp twice on the same side, because it weakens the crimp, in fact. And always leaving a little bit on the edge with your crimp, so you've got a nice little flare there that's going to protect the line. Now, I want to try and make this as straight as possible so it sits inside the skirt nicely. So you'll find if all lines got a memory, if you twist one way, you'll get quite an exaggerated arc in the line. But then if you twist back the other way, it'll certainly be a lot less. And then you can just sort of bend it into shape at the end. So twist it that way. The bend is quite a bit less. I'm going to sort that out at the end. And then I'm just sliding my top crimp on and just having that sitting flush. Now, because there's two crimps, there's no need for me to burn the end of the mono. That's going to be plenty strong enough with two crimps. I'm just going to bloody twist it again. I haven't got extremely tight twists in the line. And once again, I'm just crimping that in place. Now that that's crimped down, I'm going to want to get rid of some of that bend. So I'm just going to be bending that by hand against the natural memory in the line, just to try and get it straight. It will spring back for a little while, but once you've run the lure, you don't have to run it for very long, you'll find that it'll just straighten out naturally. But that's getting pretty straight there. Now it's just a case of sliding that all up. And there you go. As soon as we crimp a loop in the other end, we're going to be ready to go. Now on this end, I'm just sliding on my third and final crimp, a little bit more plastic tubing, bringing the other end back through the crimp. And with this one, because it's a single crimp, I'm just burning the end of the mono just to make a nice little lump there, sliding that up to the crimp. The plastic tube goes up against the crimp on the burned end, and I'm just pulling that down. Form a loop, and then crimping it all in place. Now that's ready to clip onto your line and troll this thing around, the $4 Slayer or Kodak Killer, that is ready to go and catch marlin and tuna. And that will run in all sea conditions. In fact, while it's very light, it runs extremely well in rough conditions. I don't know what it is about these film canisters, but they suck onto the water. I've pretty much always got one out. I've caught literally hundreds of marlin on them, tuna, all sorts of fish, well, as you've seen on the show, and you can have a lot of fun with having a lot of variations. A squid shell, you can see this one here has been absolutely thrashed to death. It's caught a whole bunch of marlin, tuna, all sorts of stuff. Again, just a black film canister on the end. And it doesn't have to be a film canister. These things come on the bottom of fishing rods, the old rod butt. They can give your lure a different action, again, very light. A friend of mine with the old rod butt won a $50,000 prize in a game fishing tournament catching a big blue marlin. So again, the squid shell, that has worked excellent. A little bit more than the $4 Slayer. I think I paid $8 for these squid shells, but it's a very cheap and affordable way to rig up a lure. You will find that will catch a lot of fish. All of the bits and pieces you need, you can pick up at your local Hunting and Fishing New Zealand store. And for just a few bucks, with a little bit of know-how, you can get out there and catch yourself a marlin.